Star Cosmos. White, blueberry, worm. Take it. Take the worm. Or can go back into storage. Bitch. Those can go into a stack. That can come off my head. Plant fiber. Stack worth. I might have delicate fur in two locations, but... Any of these dandelions? No, they're all daisy. Got a couple of deviled eggs. Let's cook some more. Five in total. I accidentally made a fried egg. This is what I wanted to cook. I guess we can sell the fried egg. Do we already have black jeans? No, so they go in there. Let the kitty take its poop. Off we go on our adventures. Sure. Where am I supposed to be going? This way. Except there's a dandelion here. Carrot there. Does it? Yep, that does that. Okay. Chest in here is up. Seas, I don't want you. Don't want you. I think leaf probably has to go somewhere. That's it. Okay, we got that one. Now, we just have to make our way like over. Should know where you are. Where are you? That's not this one. Oh, cabbages. Over this way. There's one under a rock. skirt. To Hippo Island. We're having mild luck already today. White dandelion. Which ones do I need? Blue and purple. So probably this one. Go away, carrot seed. Yep, that's purple. It's a regular orange. Wasn't a terrible day. Next up is going to be feeding the beetles. Beetle. Kinda annoying under rock ones. Yeah, bud. There, have some, totally not poop. Don't feed, craft all. Hey, Lorenzo! How you doing today? Honey Island. That was a terrible jump. Will we still make it? It's adorable. The music is really calming. There's a lot to do. So you will... This'll keep you busy for a while. If you look at Potion Paws at all, I would suggest that as kind of DLC for this. There are a couple of items that you unlock in Garden Paws by buying Potion Paws. But, I mean, to me, the main selling point is it's an absolutely adorable game with a ton to do that is... It's got set breakpoints that make it easy to not, like, lose your entire day to. But if that's what you're into, lose your entire day to it. It's a fun game. Plus, it's not terribly expensive. The devs are pretty active, too. Most recent update added succulent pets a couple of weeks back. I am not 100% sure on that. I don't particularly see why they shouldn't be able to. The way multiplayer works in this game is, basically someone will host an online server. And people can join the server. Making all these backpacks, I've run out of cloth. I have only a little bit left to sell in my shop. Collect some plant fiber to me. I have enough coin to pay you for 100 plant fiber. Are you? Now, are you in a cave? No. Are you? Sound is loudest behind you. Okay. Thanks, Sully. Interesting that one can be opened without... But in general, if you're on the fence about whether to get this game or not, get it. Can't pick up poop. Can at least grab, like, the feathers and stuff, though. Is there something that's worth chucking? I'd rather have more poop than daisies. Also met a lot of cool people through playing this game. And I just play offline and stream it. That is a weird sentence. It makes sense, I swear. this. I just said no to some of you. Quiet beep at me. Oh wait, no. I need those for something. Chicken egg. No, right. Tall white flowers can be sold, though. Oh. Feathers are in here. I really need to organize. I say that repeatedly, and then nothing changes. I know there's delicate fur somewhere. I will organize one of these days. I'll probably, like, log on off stream at some point and organize. Pond is in my inventory. I keep forgetting those are there. I would like to put those for sale. This goes in there. Dungeon. Dungeon, dungeon, dungeon. God, I keep forgetting where the dungeon is. Is back right there. That's the dungeon. I just want the enter the dungeon quest off of my quest log. You have your wand equipped to... Yes, I know, 3 hours. I just did a dumb, didn't I? I should have stuck my stuff in storage. Skin unlocked. Go to floor one. What are these things I'm picking up? Are they healing me or something? Destroyed. Oh, okay. Hello, random bullet hell. What's this? Find the exit. It's the exit, but what's this would be to go forward? Accuracy 62%. Shards earned. Not the most complicated thing. Dungeon stone. What makes it dungeon stone, and what do I do with it? Ad's gonna be starting up in a second. Time alive, level time alive. 75% accuracy. Took no damage. Do I just, like, keep going until I... Is it gonna pick that up or not? Okay. I think the last time I was in a dungeon, I just took the exit for some reason, rather than trying to continue. Okay, so there's a variety of biomes that I'm assuming will drop, like, different types of items. I think you also said that you don't really do dungeons very much, so you wouldn't know as much. Come from. Next, I guess. So we're on floor 4. Is it like 3 hours no matter what? Or can it take? So the question is the only limitation your health? Which I don't think is really much of a limitation unless this ramps up. Or things jump me from behind. But isn't a big deal, guys, he says. But these things do give you health by the looks of it. Just don't stand still around those guys for too long. More damage to it the closer you are, but of course it's harder to dodge. My accuracy is going to be garbage this level, but space in inventory. I don't know, like, what most of this stuff does. Demon's just staying out of their leap range, really. Percent of what they're any good at is leap. Jewel down. Relic. Heart pin, double damage when you have one. What? Does that just work as long as it's in my inventory, or...? Locked dungeon crate blueprint. I guess I get access to some stuff for going deeper down into the cave. That was a really simplistic level. Floor 7. Destroy the rituals. Yeah, that just seemed to, like, drop. That was close. Heals, please. Heals, please. So there's like specific items to heal me. Okay. Okay. So apparently we wake up at hash. Ah, you're back. Maybe you're not so clueless after all. So what do you do have to report? Dungeon shards from the monsters? Adventurers Guild would like to buy all the dungeon shards you find, but studying the dungeon shards, maybe you can learn more about how these monsters are being animated. I have a crate of dungeon shards and coins in the back. You can trade your dungeon shards for coins there. This thing? Trade all dungeon shards. Ah, so you can make some coin doing that. There's also... Wait, sometimes you can find treasure bags from instead of just like golden coins. Fish bait again. Fish bait is small insects. Okay. Oh, hey. I mean, if it wants to fall right in front of me, I'm not gonna say no. Dandelion, deviled eggs, grilled fish, money, flower storage crate. Full habitat. You too, Pixie. Thanks for stopping by. Hope your next Resident Evil stream doesn't scare you too much. If it is a horror game. What do I need? One more dandelion? Yeah. Yes, you're getting tired. Oh, I completely forgot about the wanderer. You're gonna pass out soon, I know.